Hi guys, my name is the Phann, and faintly on the background here you can see, wait, why can you see my mouse cursor? Go away please, thank you. Alright, Skyrim doesn't like alt-tabbing. This is a game called Skyrim. It's actually called The Elder Scrolls V Skyrim. You may have heard of it. This video is gonna be a kind of a vlog thing. We have actually a... No, not that button. I still don't remember the buttons. what we have here is we have sort of a two-part video going. The first one is the Skyrim part, which is gonna be kind of a vlog. And then we have a Grand Theft Auto part on the sort of second half of the video, or maybe the last third or something. Not sure yet how long this is gonna run. But I'll talk about that later. For those of you who are in the know about Skyrim, this is running about 49 different mods right now, so there's possibly some things you have not seen on your regular out-of-the-box Skyrim. I'm a level 9, I'm fairly early in this. I reinstalled this game, I think, last week. Let's see my... we have Blood on the Ice has started, that's the Windhelm serial killer thing. The Dragonborn, that's the DLC quest. The main quest is at the Horn of Jürgen Windcaller, I think. After demonstrating my ability to learn words of power and to shout, the Greybeard Arngeir has sent me on a final trial. So I've been to see the Greybeards. There will be possibly slight spoilers here. I'm not going to actually do missions. I thought I'd do sort of a alchemy run grind kind of thing while I talk, because that's fairly easy to do. I want to level up alchemy, so I think I'm going to travel between different cities and the alchemy stores and try to both earn some money and learn some alchemy. Water looks nice, doesn't it? There's a mod for that. Why would I need to actually have a vlog? I actually have a couple of things I'd like to talk about here. I assure you it is not just because I like hearing my own voice. Hello mountain flower. If you look at the embers, I think there's also a mod going on with that. That's kind of nice. I would like to actually talk about my channel a little bit. Some things I've noticed.
Need a ride?
Let's hire this and go to, I think, Solitude. Is that where I'm? I think so.
Climbing back and we'll be off.
I don't remember everything. Couple of things about my channel. First of all,
first time to Solitude. Beautiful old city.
Yeah, shut up. First of all, my channel status, I think, is kind of a State of the Union thing. I think my channel is doing rather well. I've been putting out regular video game stuff for a while now. I've been actually doing between like 2 and 4 videos a week for a while now. I might slow down a bit, but I think I can do like at least 1 video a week for a long while still. Although I own a lot of games on Steam, but I have seen that I've done quite a few of the obvious ones for videos. Some of them I have recorded but haven't even uploaded yet, so I have scheduled stuff for like July and stuff. It's actually, by the way, I should mention, I'm recording this at Monday evening on the 30th of May. I hope to get this uploaded by tomorrow, by Tuesday, or possibly later tonight. So I have stuff scheduled all the way till, I think, through the end of July for if I'm going 1 video per week.
If you've come to Solitude to join the Legion, speak to Ricker. If not, just keep your nose clean.
Okay, fuck off.
Or you'll end up like rugby.
And I might actually do even more than that. I probably will do more than that unless something happens, but I can assure you I have stuff that's uploaded and scheduled on YouTube, because I upload stuff and then I schedule it for later, because I try to, like, sometimes I make 3 or 4 videos a day, but I don't think it's a good idea to just put them all out on the same day. Wait, oh. Alright, that's not the city gate yet, that's... So I schedule them and I try to, like, I like to keep one video a week at least. I just think that's a nice idea, and I mostly try to not have more than one video a day. Yes, I got the butterfly. So anyway, I got, as I'm trying to say here, I got stuff that's already uploaded, scheduled once a week through the end of July, I think, and I got about 20 other videos that I have recorded of different, all different games. And I will, when I have the time and the inclination, I will upload those and schedule them. So I think my channel is gonna keep chugging along nicely for at least the foreseeable, well, at least for the next couple of months. Anyway, the Deus Ex thing is, well, if you've been following my Deus Ex Let's Play, it's there was a long pause, but I have done two or three videos since the pause. Oh god, we have the, there's a hanging. Oh wow, look at the lighting, that's unfortunate. There's a lot, I have a lighting mod that's probably not working as it should right now. We should go see the execution, I think. There's a, one mod that adds a whole lot of collectible stuff here in the city. You betrayed the people of Sol. Okay, I think we need to kind of, I'm gonna shut up for a while and you can listen to a bit of the story if you want.
Such is our way. Such is the ancient custom of Skyrim and all lords.
Wonder if I could actually save him. Probably not. You know what, guys? Let's try something that I wasn't planning, but I have an autosave when I enter the city. Maybe if I go try and, I don't know if that's dumb. I probably can't kill those guys. Nah, let's not bother. Those guys are probably immortal anyway. I just had the idea to go and try and go and kill those two dudes, but nah. Well, that dude died. That's a minor plot point of the game. Spoiled for you there. But it's quite an old game already, so.
Some gate guard you are.
Wait, what the hell? Oh, what the shit is this? Oh wow, there's floating bits of hanging moss here. Something's not right in the town of Solitude. Deus Ex, we were talking about Deus Ex. This is the reason that these videos are called Phann Rambles. I don't. You might be able to notice that I don't have a script with me here. On my tablet I have a list of things that I need to talk about, but holy shit, that looks nice. Okay. I have a list of things I want to talk about, but no more than that. And truly, one of the mods is adding a great deal of stuff to collect here. This is all just alchemy ingredients, if you don't know the game. Everything that I can harvest like this is usually an alchemy ingredient. Oh, hello, healing potion. Deus Ex. Concentrate. The Deus Ex series, it's still happening. I did a long hiatus because of, well, frankly, depression and laziness and all kinds of things like that. But I have done a couple of videos this year even. And when I say long break, I mean long break. That's like 2 years break or 2.5 or something. But I have played the entire game and I have the like raw material. It's just, it takes kind of a lot of work to actually edit it into the kind of video that I started doing, so just to have the opening music and stuff. Let me see what the fuck are you? I wonder if that guy was talking to me. But anyway, as soon as I will get off my ass and edit more episodes, I'll have more episodes of that. I do fully intend to complete the series, but it's a long game and it's a long videos with a lot of editing, and I'm not really great at that. But well, I would go as far as to say actually that it might not be worth, if you haven't played the game, it might not be worth it to start watching quite yet. If you have, then it might, you might be able to follow what's going on. Of course, despite the delays. It's actually the first time I'm in this particular shop, so... Also, I have a mod here that's about... It makes all the books glow that I haven't read yet, so... Just fast read some books, usually. So if you know the game, you might want to watch my Deus Ex videos anyway, as they come. If you haven't played it, then you might want to wait until the series is a little closer to completion. It's nowhere near that now. What's next? I have my list here. Well, I have some other stuff that I need to want to edit. Like most of my videos, the kind of stuff that I can keep chugging is just I usually play a game and I put the recording on and I don't actually edit it. Because I think that has a little bit of value, at least, because you get my genuine first reactions to stuff. But there's a couple of things I like to do that I think I'm gonna do that need a little more work. One of them is... That lady can't even sell me things, so I don't...
You're a traveler, correct?
Oh, for fuck's sake. She has a quest for me before I can buy stuff.
Wonderful. I haven't heard from her lately.
I could try to get more information. Okay, let's see. What have we got for sale?
You're an alchemist, then.
So what we are going to do here is... The thing is, I'm just going to buy the cheap alchemy stuff and then I'm going to use that to learn more alchemy. Also, before I go, I need to take some healing potions, I think. Oh, hello, you got the good stuff. No, don't.
So you're interested in my potions and ingredients?
As I was trying to say, I have a couple of things that need a little bit of editing that I want to do. And I honestly can't tell even how I do them. I can't tell how soon I will publish them because that's sort of a separate thing. Because that's because I don't play new games like when they come out. So I don't think there's much reason to try to have any particular video out as soon as it's ready. I would rather just have a steady supply of things on my channel. So I have a couple of things. The first one is I actually bought a bundle of games again. My name is Phann and I'm a bundle addict. It was a bundle of those sort of generic simulator games. I had like two or three farming simulators, and there was a tow truck simulator and some even weirder ones. And I played them and they were all horrible. They were all from the same company. I think it's a German company. I'm not sure, but I think it is a German company that just makes them, and they're really quite terrible.
Don't forget me next time you need herbs and potions.
And I played them all and I recorded a bit of them, but I thought I would not do my normal thing, and I thought instead I could edit them into one video. That video should be titled Simulation Sickness, I think. But I have to edit that. Another thing I kind of... Actually, here we have the... This actually, the interface here is a little different from Skyrim because I have the Sky UI mod, I think. I'm gonna try to do as many unknown potions as possible here, just to learn what the ingredients do, and then I'm gonna see if I can do any expensive potions so I can make them and sell them. So that's what I'm doing here, if you're wondering. So another thing I will do is I have there's the new King's Quest game. They made I don't know if it's a reboot or I think it might actually be like a sequel, really. But it's a new King's Quest game, and it's an episodic adventure game, because all adventure games are episodic these days. And what they did was, I don't even know who actually put it out, but what they did was they released the first episode for free just a couple of weeks ago. Might not even be that long, actually. And what I've been doing, I've been playing that, and I kind of want to do a let's play of the first episode. I've done like the very first bit of that episode, but I need to play the rest of it and record it and then see if I want to edit it. But that is highly likely to be something that's coming in the coming months. Again, with the scheduling, I can't really say how I want to do it yet. And there is a third thing that I'm not entirely sure I want to do, but maybe I do want to do it. And that would be a look at some of the Larry games. Leisure Suit Larry. I don't know how to pronounce that word. Is it Leisure or Leisure? You know Larry games. It's just Larry games. Let's call them Larry games. The thing is, some time ago, there was a remake of the first Larry game, and I bought that and I played a little bit of that and actually recorded it, but it kind of turned out to be really disappointing. But I didn't actually put that video out. You haven't seen it in my channel yet. And the thing about that is, I thought I would, since I actually own the old Larry games as well from GOG, I thought I could actually make a sort of comparison video of the remake, and there's actually two original versions. There's the, like, the original where you have to type in the commands, and then there's the VGA version where you can actually use a mouse. And I have both of those as well, so that's three Larry games. But I don't know, I'm not sure how to go about it, because it's not a horribly long game, but it's a long game. So I might have to actually finish possibly two or three versions of the same game to actually sort of figure out how I want to write that video. And then to further complicate that thing, what I happened to do was I bought a game called Larry Magna Cum Laude, which is the sort of, because they were, I need to go through Larry history now, don't I? And the thing is, there were three Larry games originally, 1, 2, and 3, and there's at least two versions of the first game. I'm not sure if there are like VGA versions of 2 and 3. But anyway, how it went was, there were first originally three Larry games. Then there was Larry 5, that came after Larry 3, which was weird, and actually I think part of the plot actually involved Larry trying to look for the game Larry 4, and it got all really meta. But holy shit, there's some hanging moss particles. We actually see that, right? If you look at, oh god, okay, whatever. So they made Larry 5 and 6 then. And then they made Larry 7, which is also known as Larry Love for Sale. And that's like, those six games are basically the original Larry games. And then some years later, when everybody had kind of given up on adventure games, another company got a hold of the license. They made Larry Magna Cum Laude and Larry Box Office Bust, which are actually about the original Larry's nephew, and those are not even adventure games, they're just basically minigame collections or some such shit. They're really quite bad, and I actually went ahead and I bought Magna Cum Laude. So now I think if I want to make like a Larry comparison video, I have to include that one as well, and that's just gonna take a whole lot more work. And well, if you remember what I said about Deus Ex, then that's kind of a 50-50 on whether I actually want to go through all of that work. I think it would make an interesting video though, possibly. So please do leave a comment if you'd like to see me do some comparative Larry research. No, that's a nice potion. What else? Okay, there's another thing that I would like to talk about that's also about this channel, and that's the sort of promotional thing. Something I've actually noticed on other YouTube channels is they have these like long-ass end screen things that say, basically tell people to like the video and subscribe to the channel and share the link and whatever. And I've been wondering about that. Like, I've been wondering if I should actually try to do something like that. But there's a couple of reasons I don't do it. First of all, I... that's nice, expensive. The first reason is that I kind of hate those things. They're... what happens is you get like a 17-minute video and there's actually only 15 minutes of content. Just the last 2 minutes is some kind of a end screen that just stays there, and I hate that. And above all, what I try to do on my channel is I try to make video the kind of videos that I would like to watch. So... I don't know, I think... I'm also kind of... I don't know if that's... Like, I see a lot of channels that are really big that do that. So that would kind of indicate that maybe that actually does work. Maybe it helps a bit. But I actually, that's just because they do it, it's not actually a guarantee that it actually does anything, so I don't know. I don't know if that's something I should do. And also, I really do kind of hate that. I hate watching those things. Especially if you're, especially if you have a playlist of videos. And then you have to wait like 2 minutes. Either you have to click on the next video manually, or you have to wait the 2 minutes to let the ending roll on until it ends. And that's just lame. So I actually think I came it's up with a solution. Shut up. I think I came up with a bit of a solution here. So I'm going to do this one video. This is my sort of promotional bit. And I'm going to tell you all of you. I'm going to tell all of you right now, straight away. If you like my videos, what you can do is you can click the like button. Or you can subscribe to my channel. And you should even circulate the links to your friends and loved ones. At least if they can stand my incessant swearing. Fuck, fuck, fuck. But anyway, do that, okay? And just, like, I'm just gonna say this, I'm gonna say it here, and we can just sort of, we can make it retroactively affect all of my previous videos, and we can make it just so that it also applies on all of my future videos. Just once and for all, like them, share them, subscribe, thank you. And that's it. Are we good? I think we're good with that. But, I don't think, I wonder if I said this already, but, it's also about respecting the intelligence of the viewer at least a little bit. Guys aren't dumb. You know what to do if you like a channel, right? So I'm gonna keep not including that at the end of my videos. Also, goddammit, it's a lot of work. I can't just... Mostly what I do is I put completely unedited stuff online. I do what I need to do live on the video, and then I stop the recording at the right time, and that's it. It will be a lot of work to add an end thing. So there, that's so close to leveling up. So that's my bit about channel promotion. Okay, I'm looking at my list of things to say, and there's only like two things, and these are kind of optional as well. Well, three things. The first is I actually, if you want to hear how I'm doing, well, I did get a Nintendo 2DS. I bought it a couple of weeks ago. I think it's a really nice thing. It's a lot cheaper than a 3DS, and the only thing that's really missing is the 3D capability, which I don't really think I would need anyway. I mean, the damn thing can actually take 3D photographs, but it just can't show them on the screen, so that's weird. And of course, it doesn't have the clamshell design. Okay, I think we're done here. I can steal stuff, I think, once I do the little quest she gave me. Oh, my tablet just turned off. Well, I think I can remember the rest. So I bought a 2DS. I got the it's the new Super Mario Bros. 2 special edition or something. So it came with new Super Mario Bros. 2. Also, I bought I immediately went to the eStore, the Nintendo, what is it called, eShop, the fucking Nintendo shop, and what I did was I bought Super Mario Bros. 1 and 3 from the NES on that. So that's a My Little Mario machine. It's pretty cool. So I've been also playing a little bit more of that and a little bit less PC games. I don't know if I don't think I equipped. I don't even know how you would go about recording stuff on the 3D on the 2DS. I'm not sure if I want. It's fucking Super Mario. I'm not gonna make videos of that. Also, I bought the Mega Man Legacy Collection just so I can punish myself if I need to do penance for something and play really hard games as punishment. So that's a thing, and one other thing, I just saw this on the news and it's kind of pissing me off still. I already told IRC about this, but there's a game coming out called Hyper Light Drifter, and it's sort of a retro inspired game. And so what they decided to do is they have a special edition going. You got like I think a poster and soundtrack CD and that sort of regular stuff. Oh, hi, I can have free weapons. Thank you. All that regular stuff, and what they also did... Oh, I haven't... Oh, this guy's an Amulet of Talos. Maybe I should take that one. What they also did with Hyper Light Drifter is they decided to include an SNES, a Super NES cartridge with it. It's a cool looking card. It's kind of a neon purple, something like that color. Holy shit, there's something, one of my mods has fucked with the hanging moss models, whatever. It's a nice looking cartridge, yes, but what really bugs me is it's a prop. It doesn't do anything. You can plug it into your Super NES and it doesn't do a one goddamn thing. That annoys me a little bit. I think, like, it's a cool idea, like, kind of, but I wish there was actually... You could at least put something in there. Like, I mean, obviously, I think... I don't know a lot about the game, but I... Is there a dragon here? I don't know a lot about the game, but I do think it probably won't work on an SNES, so... You can't just put the game in there, but you could do something like... Just fucking... Like, do a demake of it. Do like a 16-bit demake of like the first level of the game and put that there or something like that. Or you could even... What you could even do is you could... take the soundtrack of the game. I assume it has music, I don't know this for sure. But just take the soundtrack and just make like a... Make a version of the soundtrack on the... SNES sound card and put that there. Just put something. It's not that hard. Then go just see this farm here. Just so I can get it on my map. Thank you, Catalyst Farm. Just put fucking something in there. No, not that I was actually... I don't think I was going to buy that game anyway. I severely doubt I would have. But still, that just bugs me a little bit. So let's see. I don't want to go somewhere else. Where do you want to go? I should go to Falkreath because the Jarl sent me a letter. I don't want to go to Markarth yet. There's a whole bunch of bullshit there. Let's try Mortal. I don't even remember all the towns, but I think Mortal is someplace I can go next. So anyway, Hyper Light Drifter Special Edition kind of annoys me. So there's one more thing, I think. It's the Grand Theft Auto thing. Basically, I'm gonna cut this bit of the video short. Oh fuck, there's some bullshit going on here as well. I don't wanna see your plot, dudes. Put your plot away, please. Wonder where the Oh, for fuck's sake. Oh, god damn it, it's a dragon. Isn't it? Can I go inside somewhere? Just to... unlock Alva's house. Fuck. I don't want to fight a dragon. Let's go inside Falion's house. That's good. Oh, okay. Oh, hello, there's a yellow book. Okay, now we have fucking daydream music. Great. I'll deal with the dragon once I'm off the air, off air with you, but... the Grand Theft Auto thing, the next part of this video is... basically what I did was, I had some... well, actually I had a lot of recordings on in Grand Theft Auto 5. And I went through them a couple of weeks ago. And I deleted most of them because they weren't very interesting. But I took some of them and I edited them together and I added some commentary. And we're gonna take a look at them for the other part of this video. It's not quite entertaining enough for its own video, I'm sad to say, but it's just something I want to put out there so I can delete the files. So there, that's me pretty much done for now with this vlog. I'm gonna do the sign off here because the rest of this has already been sort of pre-recorded, so I just need to edit this together and put it online. So until we next meet, my name is the Phann and I hope you all have a fantastic day. So have some GTA 5, all of you. Alright, so we're doing commentary in post-processing now. This is weird. Here's the first clip of this GTA clip. What I'm trying to do is I'm trying to get my parachute here to land on the moving train, which proves to be more difficult than I first suspected. For the reason because in GTA, of course, the cops usually come by and try to stop me from having any kind of fun. So if I'm on a moving train, then that would help, because I would get away. My second attempt, I think here I'm trying to actually land the helicopter on a moving train instead of parachuting. I haven't got to the like reliable methods yet. But this is also kind of tricky. And I do believe in this clip we don't actually manage to do that. You can see the helicopter is kind of taking hits, and yeah, I just have to bail just before it explodes. Alright, another attempt here. I think there's the same deal. Got a helicopter, we got a moving train. Trying to land it. This commentating, by the way, is really weird because the way I'm doing this, I don't actually hear the audio from the original video. Not that there's a lot to hear, but still. I'm just watching silent footage. Okay, let's see, does this actually... oh, we made it actually, we got the helicopter to land, but I think there's a little bit of a flaw here. If you notice the placement of the helicopter door. So we try to exit the helicopter, we fall the fuck off. And we get hit by the train, and the helicopter explodes. So now it's just heli-fail 3, so there's another failed attempt. Because whenever the clip changes, you can see a little bit of a title on the top left there. And I'm trying not to miss those, because I don't remember what's going on. Anyway, it is heli-fail 3, and this is another attempt to... trying to... just waiting for the train here. Waiting for the train to come out of the tunnel. There we go. So you know the camera controlling while you're trying to control the helicopter in there's a moving train in there. There's a lot of moving parts in this whole operation here. The train was this train is not very long either. I think there are longer trains in the game. But this one was too long. And we failed. Okay, now it's just Heli Rampage, so this is one of the ones where I actually managed to land on there and just do something. The whole point is to get on a train and then start shooting at people and have the train be your escape vehicle from the cops. We had a black helicopter this time, I think that was. Here we go, we put it in the... Actually, when I exit the helicopter, it spawns me outside of the train, but I just realized that I can climb on a moving train just like that. Which actually comes in very useful later. And I realized I didn't actually need a helicopter either, I just need to stand by the tracks and wait for the train to come. Just jump on. Well, at least when you have the sort of lower carriages. That fucking driver was an idiot. Just wait for the train to pass. So of course the first objective is to destroy the helicopter. I believe. No, it takes a little bit more with the... soldier, I think. No. Actually, I decided to use a sticky bomb instead. Or not. No, it's back to assault rifle to finish the job, okay. No, now I don't actually... I don't have a sound and I don't have the game user interface on, so I don't actually know when the cops are after me in this video. While I'm doing this narration. This was a great and well thought out method of doing this. Well, anyway, you can probably see what's going on better than me here. Shooting at a tractor, because fuck tractors. Oh, there's a little bit... I think somebody's shooting at me already. There's just some blood on the floor there. So yeah, the basic idea is, of course, to evade cops by being removed. The trains in GTA V don't ever stop, actually. Which is fortunate. Although, of course, there are stretches where it's hard to hit anything because there really isn't anything that close. There are bits of track that go by the big highways, actually. Here you can see the room alternate wind farm. I think that's what it's called. Another thing you might notice is there's no music here because I chose not to. I first edited these clips with the Rockstar editor. And I could have put in music there, but I didn't know how much of it was licensed and shit, so... Huh, we got the motorist there. Biker. Fuck bikers. I didn't know how much of the music was actually sort of licensed and... how much I could use on YouTube and still monetize my video with my own ads. Because I'm only in it for the money. No, I just didn't want to get copyright strikes or copyright claims or whatever the fuck that goes. Also, we got some animals there. Also, what I noticed was that the Rockstar editor, it really was a little bit disappointing. Like, I think, if you compare it to something that, like a replay editor in a basic video game, then it's okay. But I was expecting a little bit more from Rockstar. Especially the one thing that I really didn't understand was the fact that I would think that, like, the game is... If I understood it correctly, the game is... Like, if they did it the right way, then the game would only record, like, sort of data, movement data, and sort of, like, just the data of where objects are in the recording, and not, like, the actual video footage. And I think they do that because you can move the camera around in it. When you're editing a video. So in that case, I would assume that you would get to when you render the video, you would get to render it at the maximum sort of graphical fidelity of the game, even if it took like longer than the video's length to render it, because it doesn't matter because you're not playing it. But actually, the editor refused to do that for some, like mostly it does it, yeah. But there's some sort of effects that it refuses to use even in the video rendering if you don't have them on in the game settings to begin with. And I don't have them on because I don't have the greatest possible graphics card on my computer. And that's just, I don't understand why you could do that in the video rendering, since you don't have to aim for like 60 FPS. Or you can aim for 60 FPS, but you don't have to get this all 60 frames in 1 second. You can take your time when you're rendering the video. But no, okay, let's see, what is this? This is the Rampage. So I think we have another successful attempt here. Also, there was a... Oh yeah, this is the one where I try to use my parachute again. You can't really see how well I'm going because I use the custom camera here. That was a great fucking landing. Oh dear. But by this time I know what I can... I can just do this, so... And if I know I can do that, why do I even need a fucking parachute to begin with? I don't know. That's a question for me who was actually playing the game. Here we are on the Lando car. So yeah, also the editor was a little bit clunky. A little bit clunkier than I would have liked. Like, I think what I would have liked was to kind of be sort of a live cameraman myself, just, you know, move the camera by myself live while the action played out. But I couldn't do that. I could set a camera angle relative to the player and just set it any way I want. And then if I wanted to have a different camera angle, I had to make a set mark on the video and then just choose another camera angle that would go on to the next mark, and so that was a bit clunky. And especially since it wasn't really designed for like sort of mouse and keyboard sort of real work computer setup. It was designed to be used with a controller as well as keyboard and mouse, so we had lots of sort of unnecessary menus that we didn't have in a proper video editor, of course. I'm sure you still, if you take your time, you sure can still get some amazing things done with it. I haven't looked at a lot of videos on YouTube about GTA, but I know you can probably do that anyway. But I don't really have the patience, and I don't really have the creativity, to be honest, to do anything too cool. This just, right here, I'm passing down the least boring bits of things I had recorded. I had recorded a lot of stuff, actually. Took me a couple of hours, at least a couple of hours, to actually go through all the clips that I had recorded. And I deleted most of it. I had some like super random bits, like, but I mostly just had to have some of these rampages, and then I think after this one we still have this last rampage one of this clip, we have one where I show some of the multiplayer bugs, which were amusing looking. But that's about it. I do kind of think that if you... Oh yeah, this is a fantastic ending to this. Direct your attention to the screen. And you're looking... Fantastic ending of this rampage. We're in a tunnel. I'm standing on the roof of the I'm just waiting to get out of the tunnel so I can keep shooting at people. But as it turns out, this one we don't have the clearance for. So here's some multiplayer bugs. This is when I was playing GTA Online. That's my character on the left there, and that's some That's some people being raptured all the way to my apartment. I set a fixed camera here actually, and I just have my guy just walking around. But yeah, I have no idea what's going on. This was actually recorded. I don't even remember when this was recorded, so I don't think this is the current feature of GTA Online. But it is kind of amusing.